Beautiful people, and welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, my name is Roslyn. On this channel, I feature lifestyle, inspiration, and self-care. In today's video, we are going to be exploring the topic of self-love. So for today's topic, we're going to be looking at self-love. We know how to love other people, we know how to care for other people, but do we really take the time to really focus on ourselves? I want to tell you a couple of things that I think that are very important when it comes to self-love. So the first tip that I want to share is to make yourself a priority. Now, a lot of people have work, they have school, they have kids, they have a husband, they have businesses, all of these other things that they have to give their attention to. I think it's so vitally important for you to make time for yourself and make yourself a priority. When you do this, you feel a lot better as far as taking care of yourself. You also have the opportunity and the capacity to think, because as the saying goes, you cannot pour from an empty cup. If you're trying to make sure that everybody else is satisfied and taken care of and you're not taking care of yourself, then there is going to be a problem. Usually, when I do this a lot and I'm so focused on everybody else, I get to the point where I am so burned out. So over the last few years, I have decided to intentionally make sure that I am taking care of myself first. You may have heard me say this in another video before, but a lot of times I get up 2 to 3 hours earlier than everyone else in my family. For one, it's very peaceful in my house. There's nobody running around, no one screaming, no one asking or demanding anything of me. The phone's not ringing, the TV's not on. It's just super quiet and I get to think, I get to meditate, I get to do a lot of the things that I need to do to help me stay peaceful and calm, and it also helps me throughout the day. The second thing is to stop criticizing yourself. Here's the deal, no one is perfect, so you're going to make mistakes. What you have to do is give yourself grace. A lot of times you just have to suck it up, learn from it, and move on. There's no need to kind of beat yourself down, talk to yourself and tell yourself things like, oh my gosh, you're so stupid, you're so dumb, you know, why'd you do that, you know, what have you. All those negative thoughts and emotions, you have to kind of push them out of your mind, and you can't worry about criticizing yourself for every single thing that you do. Again, you just have to look at it as a learning opportunity and then move on. The third thing is to compliment and celebrate yourself. I think it's so important to make sure that we are celebrating ourselves. It helps to first build self-esteem, and that is very important. Whether you're a young person, whether you're an old person, doesn't really matter. You want to make sure that you are building yourself. So if you put on a cute dress and you get in the mirror, you know, you can look at yourself and say, oh my gosh, this dress is so cute. It looks very good on me. Regardless of what your body type looks like, your body type is your body type. Of course, if you're a little bit what you consider overweight and you want to lose weight, create a plan to lose weight. And especially when you start losing weight, go ahead and celebrate when you lose weight. Do something like take yourself to the movies, or do a staycation and, you know, buy you a new outfit, or put on a swimsuit and go swimming, or go to the beach. But do something to celebrate yourself. A lot of times we don't celebrate ourselves because we don't really think about it. We think about other people. We think about other occasions that are out there, the holidays. But we don't just each week, each day, pick something very positive about us to celebrate. I know a lot of people have coworkers, they have friends, they have families that say, oh my gosh, you're so good at this, or you're so good at that. Celebrate the fact that you are good in whatever craft that you're doing, whether it's an everyday job, whether it's being a good, you know, parent, whether it is being a good spouse, whatever it is, learn how to celebrate and be in a place where you're happy where you are. The fourth tip that I have for you in self-love is take care of your body. So important that you're eating healthy, you're working out, you're reading, you're doing all those things to help your body live a good and fruitful life. So with eating healthy, there are a ton of different things that you can do. There are a ton of different apps that you can look into if you want to change up how you're eating or you want to eat a little bit better. There are so many websites and blogs that you can look at to get really good recipes. There's Pinterest, there's Instagram, where people share a lot of their stories or videos on cooking different meals and stuff. But you want to make sure that you are trying to be the healthiest person that you can be, because this is going to help your body as well. And then when you add the working out to it, this is also going to multiply that effect. And so it's going to help you live a really healthy lifestyle. So then you won't be so prone to getting sick and all of these other things that come with not eating healthy and not exercising. The fifth tip that I have for you is being your own best friend. A lot of times I talk to myself, and as the old saying goes, you're not crazy unless you respond. So I don't respond to myself, but I talk to myself a lot. I talk through problems and situations, and I'll even ask myself questions like, well, what should you do in this instance? And I'll think about it. I'm writing it down. I'm just going through the motions a lot of times when I'm working on projects and proposals for clients. I'm doing this. And even sometimes in everyday life, when I'm thinking through, you know, a process, I am being my own best friend. I love those moments where I can just curl up on the couch and I can watch a movie and kind of analyze and say, oh my gosh, that was a great movie. I'm enjoying my company of just it being me. I'm okay with it being me. And I just think that being your own best friend is so, so important, because a lot of times, especially with females, during the time that you're dating and maybe possibly wanting to get married, we're in such a rush to find that perfect one that we don't really take the time out to really love on ourselves, to really get to know ourselves, and then to figure out what it is we like and what we don't like. So what happens is, you get in a relationship, you're super happy about the relationship, and you accept everything because you haven't established what it is that you really like. You haven't created any boundaries around, you know, what you like and what you don't like. So you don't know, you're just open to everything. So I think it's so important to really be your best friend, to understand who you are, what you have to give. And that way you don't actually get the short end of the stick when other people are approaching you, whether it be a friend, a female who wants to be your friend. You understand boundaries in reference to what you want a friendship to look like mutually, and then also what you want a relationship to look like mutually. So I think it's super, super important for you to practice being your own best friend. Well guys, that's it for this video. Thank you so much for watching. I will see you in the next video. Bye.